These divers are gearing up to head 400 feet underwater. Their bodies will experience immense, almost fatal pressure that can literally turn the very thing keeping them alive against them.
The longer you stay down there, the more gas, mostly helium, also nitrogen, onboards into your tissues, into your blood, into your muscles, into your bones. It's just building up inside your body. And, you know, you have to let that out.
The Twilight Zone is one of the most mysterious and dangerous places on Earth. Only an elite team can handle the complexities of diving at these depths and conduct scientific research. Their job is a race against time to survey these deep water coral before they come under serious threat from pollution and warming ocean temperatures.
I would say less than 10, 15 scientists worldwide go to those depths. And because of that, everything is new. Everything is novel. We don't know what's there because nobody goes there.
Luis Roca is one of only a dozen divers in the world with enough expertise to reach the Twilight Zone, a place you don't want to visit alone.
We're dive buddies, so Luis and I were almost inseparable, both on land and underwater.
Bart and Luis are equipped with nearly 180 pounds of gear, like fins, bailout tanks, propeller scooters, and dive computers. These are all essential to surviving in the Twilight Zone.
Getting all the gear on the boat and getting ready to drop into the water is definitely the most intense time. We make sure our straps are all clipped, we make sure our valves are on. It's hot, you're in the sun, in neoprene, black, dying basically.
The key piece of equipment that will keep Bart and Louise alive is called the rebreather. Because of the levels they're going, the normal mix of oxygen and nitrogen actually becomes toxic.
The deeper we go with nitrogen, the more narcotic it becomes. So it's equivalent of diving drunk.
We make the sign to descend. We go down together. That can be a 300-foot free fall.
When you're in a shallow tropical coral reef, it's well lit, it's warm. And as we go deeper, we see that transition. Everything becomes slower and colder and darker.
Finally, you'll start to see the bottom come up, and that's when you work. You know, that's you have your 10 minutes, your 15 minutes on the bottom.
And that's it. That's all the time that these divers can spend exploring the Twilight Zone before all that gas they're inhaling becomes lethal.
It requires constantly monitoring yourself for symptoms of all kinds of different aspects of different gases interacting with your body. So we have to be constantly thinking about our gear and ourselves, and at the same time trying to do science at those depths.
During their incredibly short window of time, the dive team have to survey their surroundings, catalog coral, and capture new species. In fact, they've been known to collect 12 new species in just a single dive.
It's really intense. All you're thinking about is catch the fish, do the job that I'm here to do. Where's my buddy? Okay, everybody's okay. What's the time? Okay, I've got a little bit more time. We have kind of our own language of hand signals and screaming gestures and taglines and things like that that we'll use to communicate. And then we'll scream at each other in our ridiculous helium voices if we see something really exciting and, you know, come over here and look at this fish.
Bart and Louise would spend hours down in the Twilight Zone if they could, but it's time to ascend.
We have an agreed upon time where we leave, what we call the TTS, the time to surface.
Ascending too fast can cause life-threatening conditions like decompression sickness or the bends. So Louise and Bart follow a very specific decompression schedule, which means ascending in stages.
If we have 10 to 15 minutes at the bottom, it could be 3-4 hours after that to come back up to the surface.
The longest stop is just before Bart and Louise surface, just 10 feet below the waterline, where they can spend up to 90 minutes. 90 minutes in just one spot.
had about 300 hours of rebreather diving now in the past few years doing this project. And when you think about it, it's probably like maybe a sixth of that is in the Twilight Zone, and the rest of it's all the decompression. But, you know, it's worth it.
Bart and Luis are just beginning to scratch the surface of the Twilight Zone, and the information they collect from these debriefs is invaluable. They're so rarely studied that we could be in danger of losing them before we fully understand them.
Every time we go to those depths, we find plastics, we find fishing gear, we find all signs of human activity, even as deep as we go, so 400, 500 feet.
And Bart and Louise are willing to go through the process of donning heavy equipment, risking decompression sickness, and spending hours underwater over and over again, just so they can better understand this world.
It's definitely worth it to be able to go down there and see places that no person has ever seen before.
Now you know what it takes to go to the Twilight Zone and back, a place less visited by humans than the moon. So what does it take to go to the depths of space? Watch this next episode to learn how to become an astronaut. Thanks for watching, and be sure to subscribe for more episodes.